Can one of you speak to the economic development part of this? The gentleman from California mentioned that you take this off the black market, you create a base of taxation. And my in-laws are in Michigan. You open the newspaper up there, it's, you know, every ad is a school to learn how to become a medical marijuana dispensary. There's, you know, ads for the dispensaries. This will create, frankly, a lot of businesses because it can't be dispensed out of the CBS.
We agree with you. Our estimation is that within 5 years, if there are at least a 250,000 patients, we're looking at potentially, and this is a very conservative estimate, at least an $860 million a year industry in the state.
Because I've heard it's $1 billion nationwide. That's, you're saying that we could almost double, that Ohio alone would provide that much sales?
We believe it's possible, yes.
How many signatures do you have right now?
What goes into that, what you think, what you're rooting in that estimation? The stuff that she was talking about.
In that estimation, it takes into account of several different factors.
You're saying full economic impact, not just sales.
We're saying full economic impact. The entire, all the myriad of factors that would go into a medical marijuana industry, the growers, the distributors, and the patients themselves.
How many signatures do you have right now?
Right now, we have just begun to gather signatures. We are gathering all of our volunteers right now, and at this point, we need to print 7,500 petition packets, send them out to all of our volunteers at various spots of the state, and we're going to be undertaking a very, very serious ground effort to get these signatures done in time.
So you're just getting started with it?
Yes.
How many do you need signatures?
We need approximately 385,000 ballot signatures.
How many volunteers do you have right now?
Right now we have over anywhere between 400 to 500 volunteers.
Are you using specifically a volunteer effort, or are you going to bring in paid circulators?
Well, we're realists. You know, we understand how elections work. And, you know, at this point, to get it on the ballot, we would like to see a combination thereof. And that will depend on the support of the people of Ohio.
How does this differ from the alternative treatment amendment that's already on the ballot? And do you foresee...